baptized by a priest of great holiness, who was just preparing to celebrate the Holy Mass. After baptizing her, he pronounced these words: "Why do you fear that child will not die but will become a holy religious? By her, God will work great wonders, and she will finish her life at a good old age, full of merit." At the age of 7, her mother took her to a convent which was near her parents' residence. Once there, she refused to leave, not understanding her mother's desire to return home. Full of delight, she begged the sisters one by one to accept her into their company. Saint Mechtilde advanced rapidly from virtue to virtue. She had a wonderfully sweet disposition, was profoundly humble, was a sincere lover of poverty, and was very devoted. She was full of tender love and compassion toward the afflicted or those in trouble. She was like a loving mother, showering upon them consolation and help, so anyone who met her would not leave without being comforted and strengthened. Everyone wanted to be with her. She was much loved by all. So perfect a religious she must have been, a treasure to the convent of Helfta. Not only had God enriched her with spiritual gifts, but also with those of nature learning, wide knowledge of literature. Her beautiful voice caused her to be appointed cantor of the convent. Mechtilde's companions often compared her to the different orders of angels and saints. They said, "This angelic virgin deserves to be compared above all with the seraphim, united so frequently in an intimate manner with that love which is God Himself." She was never tired of talking about God, and with so much favor and divine love that she enkindled the same in the hearts of those who heard her. Indeed, one might say of her as a prophet Elias, her words burnt like a torch.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Saint John the Baptist,
pray for us.
Saint Peter,
pray for us.
Saint Paul,
pray for us.
Saint Matthew,